Greetings and Happy New Year. Welcome to another edition of Curator's Corner here at the National Museum of the United States Army. Today I'm standing outside our Cold War gallery and we feature a fascinating object, the Davy Crockett nuclear weapon system. You may be asking yourself, did the Army actually make a portable nuclear weapon? And the answer is yes. So let's learn more about this fascinating weapon. In an effort to combat Soviet forces during the Cold War, the Army developed for the first time a portable nuclear weapon known as the Davy Crockett. A prototype was developed in 1958, then approved in 1961, and after testing in 1962, the Army deployed the first Davy Crockett systems with armor and infantry battalions. They were sent to the Fulda Gap in West Germany. This was the expected invasion route of Soviet forces. For 10 years, soldiers were equipped with these systems in Guam, Hawaii, Okinawa, and South Korea. This particular piece on display is an M28, made in 1962. It fired a 76-pound M388 atomic projectile that carried a W54 warhead. It had an explosive power of 10 to 20 tons of TNT. The first projectile was successfully tested on July 7, 1962. 10 days later, an Army crew fired an M388 from an M29 Davy Crockett, a larger version of the one we have on display. This weapon system consists of a 120mm recoilless gun, a tripod mount, and a telescope. The M28 had a range of about 1.25 miles and could be hand-carried and fired from its tripod by a 3- or 5-man crew or mounted on a Jeep. Test firings with non-live nukes proved that this weapon was not very accurate. Also, the firing crew had to be fairly close to detonation point. If the wind was blowing the wrong way, they could be exposed to the radiation fallout, making it unsafe for the crew and nearby friendly forces. Thankfully, the Davy Crockett was never used in combat. By 1967, the systems were removed from Europe and was fully retired in 1971. However, this weapon represented the Army's response to fight the Soviet Army on a nuclear battlefield, a real threat that shaped our defense policy after World War II. So I want to thank you for joining us for another edition of Curator's Corner. To find out more information about the museum, visit our website.